Hello, it's Mark Lanier with your video thought for the day. This week, I'm looking at five different people in the Bible, and I'm asking this question, which they may have asked in their own life. The question is, Lord, what are you doing in my life? That's a reasonable question for a lot of us to ask. And sometimes it might be obvious what God is doing, but sometimes it's a little more subtle. The hand of the Lord is not always so easily seen. And that may be the situation with today's character. Now, this is an Old Testament woman, and I love Old Testament names because they generally had meaning. Either they were directly a word or a phrase, or they sounded like a word. And so when we translate them, we tend to translate the names into an English equivalent, though we don't often get close even there. But sometimes I like to translate the names by what they mean. And so instead of calling this woman Naomi, which is what her name was in Hebrew, it sounds like the Hebrew word for pleasantness. So we could just call her Pleasantness. And she was married to a fellow named Elimelech. And we can call him Elimelech, or we could translate his name, which is, My God is King. So here is this woman, Naomi, Pleasantness, who's married to this fella, Elimelech, My God is King, and they live in Bethlehem. And life is good. They get not one, but two sons. And they're farming and living, and they've got land, and they're happy. And then, poof, a famine sets in. They don't have any land that's producing enough food for the family. They don't know what to do. Now, let me put this into a time frame. This is before Israel had kings. So Israel is just kind of ruled by community rule. There might be a priest or several priests in charge of sorts, or some judges who help the people decide what's right and wrong. But generally, it's family rule. And so Pleasantness, Naomi, and her husband, Elimelech, My God is King, decide to take their two sons and go east across the Jordan River into an area of foreign control. They go to live among the Moabites, not Israelites, Moabites. Now, while they're living there, the sons come of age and the sons both get married, but they marry Moabite women. So here's this woman whose life is wonderful and pleasant, and she lives in the pleasantness of her name with a godly husband and a marvelous life, but famine comes in, she has to move, her sons have married foreigners, and then her husband dies and both of her sons die. So now she's a widow in a foreign land, no longer pleasant, but bitter. And she's got two daughter-in-laws that aren't even Israelites. So Pleasantness, Naomi, decides Naomi decides she's going to go back to Israel, to Bethlehem. And she tells her daughter-in-laws, look, y'all stay here among your people and you do whatever you need to do. And one of the daughter-in-laws says, okay, see you, it's been fun. The other daughter-in-law, whose name is Ruth, says, wherever you go, that's where you're going to find me. Your people will be my people. Your God will be my God. And Naomi says, wow, okay, I don't know how this is going to work, but come on. So they go back. They get back to Bethlehem, and while there, Naomi sends her daughter-in-law out to kind of glean among the fields. Now, Moses' law had set it up where when you harvested your crops, you always left food around the outside, crops around the outside of the field for people who were hungry, who didn't have a job and didn't have food to glean so that they could come get theirs. It was a community support system. And so while there, lo and behold, a relative of Elimelech, the husband, the dead husband of Naomi, a relative, kind of his eye catches that Moabite daughter-in-law, widow, named Ruth. And the courtship ensues, and the bottom line is they get married. And from them is born a son who becomes the father of Jesse, who becomes the grandfather of King David. And this means that into the line of King David, which is into the line of Yeshua, Jesus, the Messiah, comes a Moabite woman. Pretty incredible. Now, Naomi, Naomi, pleasantness, might have asked in the midst of her husband dying, her children dying, losing her house, losing her field, losing her husband's job, turning into a beggar woman, what is the Lord doing to me? And the answer would have been, he's reshaping your life to fit his destiny. Because God had a plan for King David to come, and a plan not only for King David, but for the Messiah to come. And that was made possible through some very difficult times that reshaped the life and future of Naomi. So I don't know what you're going through today, but I do know that the same God is still at work. And I still know that he shapes the life of his people, not just because of me and what I need and what I want today, but because of his eternal plan and what he's doing. He will reshape us to fit into his destiny. And I don't know about you, but when I'm going through rough times, I cling to him even tighter, because the promise that I'm going through it for the good of his kingdom gives me a certain level of joy and appreciation and honoring that I might be counted worthy to contribute to the kingdom of God. More tomorrow, but that's your video thought for the day.